What's up, creative fam? Thanks for joining the podcast today. So today I'm by myself again, and I kind of wanted to talk a little bit about where I see the wedding photography industry going and kind of a little rant about photographers as well, just because recently I've had a couple of instances at weddings that have really made me think a lot more about opinions I've kind of had and kind of form those into something solid. So first of all, I want to go through some of the weddings that I've had recently. One wedding where they didn't even hire a photographer. They only hired me to shoot video, which is like, you know, no pressure. You have to get everything. And at the reception, it was something fascinating to watch. I really wish I got video of it, and I don't think I did. But basically, everyone during dinner, when I was kind of taking my break, everyone was taking selfies with their phones or gathering their family members into groups to take photos. And then there was like two or three family members that had professional level cameras, who one of them even had an off-camera flash, who were taking the photos that they wanted, you know, like a brother or an uncle or whatever, some kind of amateur photographer in the family that was like, yeah, I'll take photos and I'll do it for free. And then I had another wedding recently where the actual photographers that were hired had to literally tell a family member to stop taking photos because somehow that family's camera was setting off the actual photographer's flashes that were set up on stands. And this family member didn't listen, but it was kind of crazy. Like there was a lot of fighting photography family members in that wedding. And I really think, like, this is where I see photography going. I think very soon couples are going to start foregoing hiring professional photographers. Like, they already are. I've already filmed a wedding where there wasn't a photographer that they hired. They only hired a videographer. And I have two weddings booked in the future as well where they're not hiring a photographer. They didn't have the budget. They wanted video more than photography. They figured they have a family member that can take decent photos, and that's what they're going to do. And I think a lot of photographers will fight me or disagree with what I'm saying, but I really am starting to not understand what photographers possess differently than somebody else does with a decent camera or a decent phone even. I understand, like, come the day of, there's a lot of things that photographers do that I give them mad props for. Like, I'm not a very patient person when it comes to dealing with people, and photographers definitely have a skill set of organizing people, of family members and stuff, when it comes to taking photo, like group photos of family members. But I've just also witnessed it where when a family member is taking these photos and they're in charge, they're not afraid to kind of like put drunk Susan in line and tell her to like, to stay there and shut up. Like, you know, family members can get a little like mean with each other, and it's not perceived as like, oh, this professional is just being an asshole. I've watched it. I've like literally seen it at weddings. And if that one skill set can be taken over by a family member, I would argue that 95% of wedding photographers are gonna have a problem real soon. You know, I just think that in the next couple of years with technology, we've got iPhone 10 coming out, which takes portrait photography. I don't know how. I'm not like a tech genius or understand how that works, but the cameras that the everyday person is starting to be able to access and to have in their possession is cutting it really, really close, in my opinion, to the technical specs of some of these professional cameras that my friends are using. I think photographers need to be really aware of that and see that and understand that. I really do think that in the next couple of years, people are going to start foregoing photography. So with that being said, I also kind of wanted to just go on like a quick rant, playing off of that perspective that I have about the photography industry or the wedding photography industry and where it's going, into kind of something I'm getting frustrated about. I quit my job in January to do this full time. So I've been doing it full time since January. And for a while, I couldn't understand this under the radar preconceived idea that photographers and videographers don't get along. I tried really hard to make friends with photographers, and only in the last half year, 4 months or so, have I kind of really started to see and understand that. And I just wanted to kind of give my input as to why that is a thing and some of the reasons behind it. So when I walk into a wedding, my goal is to become friends with the photographer. Like, we're on the same team. We have the same goal. Our goal is to create physical memories for the couple. So video and photos, like, we should be a team. We should be working together. And you can talk to the many photography teams that I've worked with in the past who will refer me time and time again, because I try really hard to play well with others. And if I ask questions, like if they want to do something one way and I don't like it, or I don't understand why they're doing it, I'll ask why they're doing it. And sometimes photographers take that the wrong way and they think I'm trying to tell them how to do their job, when really I just want them to educate me as to, like, why does your camera work differently than mine? Like, what about what you're doing that I would do differently makes your job easier? But there are a few times, though, where the photographers have literally rolled their eyes at me, assuming I wasn't watching them. And it's for things that are ridiculous. Like, because I'll ask if they can take as few photos as possible during the toasts in the reception. Because, like, to be honest, photos of a toast don't make any sense. It's literally a person standing there with a microphone, and you might get a tear running down their face with a photo. Like, wait for that moment, take a photo, and then be done with it, because you can't capture the words and the audio for a toast. And I usually ask that. The reason I ask that question is because the reception is dark and the photographers are going to use a flash. And the flash shows up in the video. And if you have a photographer that's constantly taking photos of, you know, guest reactions or the person giving the toast, it's just nonstop flashing in the video. I actually had a photographer one time try and debate with me that you can't see the flash in the video because it's the same speed as the shutter. And I want to explain this because how the photographer thought that was a thing is because they didn't understand how my equipment works. So yes, like if I have a 1/60th shutter speed and your flash is at a 1/60th speed, or like, I'm really not even sure because I'm not a photographer, but I think in their mind, the idea was that the flash is the same speed as the shutter, so they sync up with each other and you can't see it. But in a second, there's hundreds of milliseconds in an actual second. Unless those things go off at the exact same time, will you not be able to see a flash in video. So, like, that whole moment with that photographer just blew my mind, because they were going outside of their lane to try and tell me that what I was doing was incorrect or wrong. And This is where the headbutting begins between videographers and photographers, is when we start trying to assume we know each other's craft. When I start out the day respecting the other person's requirement for their craft, the day runs smoothly and friends are made and boundaries are respected. But when I walk into a bridal prep and I ask to turn off a yellow lamp that is behind the bride getting ready in front of a window with natural light, and the photographer tells me, "No, we need that light," you are automatically perceiving me as secondary. You are automatically saying, "No, I'm more important. We're going to keep the light on because the photo of her getting ready is the utmost goal." And like, that's not okay. Photographers, I don't perceive you as secondary because I understand that the couple hired both of us to do a job. And again, that job is to give the couple physical memories of that day. But with that being said, I think you need to stop thinking of yourselves as having the most important role come wedding day, because honestly, I think in 2 to 4 years, you're going to be sitting in the same shoes that many videographers were sitting in 5 to 10 years ago. I believe that in that 2 to 4 years, 95% of wedding photographers are going to possess no more talent than iPhone 10 has, or that Uncle Bob with his mirrorless camera and off-camera flash has. And maybe that's coming from a perspective of not understanding your craft and maybe getting outside of my lane, but I'm saying this from a perspective of watching my clientele and watching their attitudes toward photography, and the fact that most of my couples tell me that they're more excited to get their video than their photos. And from being hired for weddings where they're stopped, like they're not hiring photographers, and witnessing a wedding where they only hired a videographer, there was no photographer, and they let family members take the photos, and they were completely, completely happy and satisfied with that outcome. I think photographers need to stop seeing me as secondary and start following my lead. Start watching what I'm doing, ask me why I'm doing it instead of rolling your eyes at me, and learn how to edit video. Because I think very, very soon you're gonna see a shift in this industry. More and more couples are foregoing photography, and it's going to be that thing where they'll see how much is left in their budget, and videography is gonna start being that vendor that they hire as soon as they have a date. I think photographers really need to take a second look. They need to fly 4,000 feet above themselves and their business and ask themselves, what do they do differently? What do they do that stands out? What do they do that is unique that Uncle Bob with his camera can't do? And if the answer to that is, oh, I can organize people, or oh, I have better lighting, or I know how to edit, like you need to check yourself. You need to see that other people can do that same thing. Uncle Bob can do that same thing because he didn't have to go to photography school to learn how to do it. He went on YouTube and watched 40 hours of YouTube videos and learned how to do it himself, and is practicing and is taking advantage of this wedding to do it for free. And that couple is saving $3,000 by letting him do it. And he knows what he's doing because he got straight to the point and learned how to do it online. Anyway, that's my rant. Thanks again, guys, for joining me on the podcast, and I'll see you next week. Bye. Hey, creative fam. Thank you so much for tuning into my podcast. If you liked it and got anything out of it, I would appreciate it so much if you gave it a 5-star rating and subscribe. I'll see you soon.